CL36 versus CL30, does it really matter? Well, yes and no. See what's coming up. Hi guys, it's Papa PC. So, CL36 versus CL30. People argue about this all the time on forums and groups. But does it actually matter in real gaming? Today I'll test two sets of Corsair Vengeance RGB 32GB on my Ryzen 7 9700X. Thanks to a friend, I could borrow a gigabyte model of a 5070 Ti, a 5080, and, to make sure that I will not run out of power, a 1000 watt version of my usual MSI MPG PSU. Of course, I will use as a base GPU my own RTX 5060 Ti and test all the way up to the 5080. So we'll test the RAM on those three games: Cyberpunk 2077, Starfield, and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Here we go. At 1080p, the CPU still plays a big role. With the RTX 5060 Ti, the CL30 gives around 3 to 5 extra FPS over the CL36. On the 5070 Ti, you still get a slight edge in competitive shooters. And with the 5080, well, that's where CL30 shows smoother frame pacing and better lows. At 1440p, the gap shrinks. On average, only a couple of FPS at best. By the time you're at 4K, the difference is basically gone. If you're gaming at 1080p, CL30 is a clear advantage. But if you're gaming at 1400p or at 4K, there's no visible difference. So here's the bottom line. 1080p with a strong GPU, CL30 gives you a small but real advantage. 1440p and 4K, well, you won't notice a difference. CL36 is perfectly fine. If you want bragging rights and the lowest latency, go CL30. But if you're gaming in 4K, your GPU matters way more than your RAM timings. So, does it really matter? The answer is only if you're chasing every last frame. But if you find them at the same price, get the CL30. It was Papa PC. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.